So the question is, could you explain create and target class? So create is a access vector permission, and a target class is a security class. In this case, target class equals Netlink audit socket. Target classes or security classes, which they are also referred to, are provided by object managers. In this case, the target class, the security class Netlink audit socket, is a security class provided by the Linux object manager. Each tar You can list the target classes, the classes available in your system, by running the isinfo c command. These are all the object classes or security classes or target classes, T classes, provided on your system. And some of them are provided by the Linux object manager, others are provided by various object user space object managers, like for example the X server object manager, the database object manager, and other user space object managers. So these are the target classes. Each target class has a set of access vector permissions associated with it. So their access vector permissions are ways to operate on object classes. Let me just show you. Each set of permissions for each object class. So for example, let me take a small one, because I run this command here, xc, which basically shows you all the security classes and the permissions that you can use for each security class. So for example, let me give you a simple one that you might be able to relate with. For example, a file. Okay, so here you have the file object class, what you see here. And the file object class has a bunch of permissions, for example, append, create, execute, write, relabel from, link, unlink, etc., etc. So these are all the things that you can do on a file. So you can execute a file, for example, you can create a file, you can write a file, you can link a file or unlink a file, you can get attributes of a file, set attributes of a file, read a file, and stuff like that. So to see all the object classes, you just run isinfo-c. If you want to see all object classes and all the permissions for each object class, then you run isinfo-xc. So now the next question is, you want to actually see, for example, let me see what the question is. How do I know if a process has set PGID permissions or other syscalls? Now, so you use SE search. So SE search allows you to query the loaded policy. So for example, if you wanna see, right. So if you want, so here you actually run SEinfo. SE search. So first you need to tell SE search for what kind of rules you want to look. So you want to look for allow rules, rules that have the allow keyword, which is the dash capital A. Then you'll use dash S to specify the source type identifier to look rules up rules for. So S for a T in this case, and then you'll look, then you can basically list that. And now you get all the rules, all the allow rules, where SVRT is a source. And it's a whole bunch of rules. And basically, here are all the permissions for each object class that SVRT is allowed. So, yeah, this is actually, you'll actually do it right. This will show you this command that you just typed will show you whether SVRT is allowed to use the set PGID permission of the process object class. And if that returns something, then it's allowed, and if it's not returned, then it's not allowed. So that's basically how you use it. You should actually really learn how to use SEinfo and SE search, because those are very handy tools. It allows you to query the policy that's currently loaded on your system, so that you actually know what what the rules are on the system. Important.